Good morning, my dear children.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you all?
Fine, ma'am.
Yeah.
Fine, ma'am.
Fine, happy, right? Then, did you learn that first 10 elements in the periodic table?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone? Yes, ma'am. Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, we are starting from Alan. Yes.
Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen.
Two more.
A neon, sorry.
Neon is the last one. Before that, one more. So many helping faces are there in the screen itself. Ellen starts with F. So?
Fluorine.
Yeah, fluorine. Okay.
Fluorine and neon.
Yeah, very good. Then Anandita, can you tell me?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon.
Very good. Lakshmi?
Yes, ma'am. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon.
Very good. Advait, Murali?
Ma'am, hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon.
Fluorine, neon. Okay, fine. Isha?
Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, oxygen,
boron,
carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon.
Okay, very good. Hira?
Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon.
Okay. Then I will give you the next 10 elements, okay? Next 10 elements in the periodic table. Then you have to learn it for the next class. Then I will ask you the remaining students, okay?
Ma'am, should we learn for the periodic table?
If you can, you should. Okay, we can at least learn first 30 elements. That will be helpful. So I will write the remaining here in the board. You can copy the names of the elements.
How much are there?
How much?
Elements. How much are there?
More than 100 elements in the periodic table. But you have to at least learn first 30 elements. Clear? Yes. So, 11th one. Just wait, children. Sodium. Okay, 11, sodium, 12, magnesium, 13, aluminium, 14, silicon, 15, Phosphorus, 16, sulfur, 17th one, chlorine, 18, argon, 19, it's potassium. And 20, calcium. These are the elements from atomic number 11 to 20. Is this clear? Starting from sodium, then magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, calcium. These are the next 10 elements. So in the next class, I will ask for the first 20 elements. Okay, starting from hydrogen till calcium. Tom, can you please read the names of the elements from atomic number 11 to 20?
Sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, calcium.
Okay. Then, Vaishnavi, can you repeat it once again?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, and calcium.
Okay. This is clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
About
yes,
the
ma'am.
Names of the elements from atomic number 11 to 20. Okay. Okay, then one more activity for you. That comes under your subject enrichment activity. That's for your internal assessment. Okay. So I think you have to, you all are familiar with PowerPoint presentations, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you should prepare a PowerPoint presentation on the topic solutions, suspensions, and colloids. Okay, a PowerPoint presentation on solution, suspensions, and colloids. You need to include, I will write it on the board, just wait. Yes, PowerPoint presentation on topic solutions, suspensions, and colloids. Okay, solutions, suspensions, and colloids. Then you need to include properties of solution, suspension, and colloid. Properties of solution, suspension, and colloid. Then examples for each solution, suspension, and colloid. Minimum two examples. Okay, then include images related to the topic. Okay, then present each topic in the form of points. Don't write a complete paragraph there. It's always PowerPoint presentation. So you should present it in the form of certain points. Okay. The form of points. Then, okay, maximum number of slides. 10. Maximum number of slides. 10. Then you can make it attractive. Attractive and colorful. Okay. So the topic is PowerPoint presentation on solutions, suspensions, and colloids. So properties of solutions, suspensions, colloids, Then examples for each type. Solutions, you have to write minimum 2 examples. You can add maximum examples. Okay. Then include images related to the topic. I think you can include the examples images, right? Images of examples. That means for solutions, there are different types of solutions. Solid solution there, then gaseous solution. Alloys are included in solution, right? Then in the case of suspension also, you can add examples, their images. Then colloids are also divided into different forms. So you can add more examples in the case of colloid. Then present each topic in the form of points. You should present it in the form of points other than paragraph. Okay. Then maximum number of slides is 10. Then make it attractive and colorful. Then which date is comfortable for you to submit, children? You can tell me one submitted date. Yeah, Amin?
Gmail.
I am asking about the submitted date.
1 week.
1 week only needed?
They need you more.
Yeah. When?
1 week plus.
Okay, that means when will your exam start? Okay. I think towards the end of September. So can you complete it with the within September 15, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so September 15th is the last date for your submission. Okay. If you can complete early, you can submit it.
Okay, sure. That's the reason.
Yeah, yeah. I will show the slide. Yeah, Nandana, what's your doubt?
3 email or WhatsApp?
2 options. It's okay. No issues. I will write the Gmail here. If it's either through WhatsApp, it's okay. So, submitted date. Okay.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
10 slides means first page also included.
Yeah.
Okay.
So maximum number of slides, 10. That's needed. Okay. This is clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Any doubt regarding the activity?
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, is there minimum number of slides?
Minimum 7. Okay, 7. Any more doubt, children?
No, ma'am.
Shall I move to the topic?
Yes.
Yes. So we already learned the first 10 elements, right? And in the next class, you will be able to learn first 20 elements. So the next part of this chapter, that's about the symbols of elements. We already learned about the first symbols of elements that was introduced by Dalton. That's in the form of certain sphere or circle with certain dots or like that. But the modern day symbols, that's fully about alphabets. Okay, the modern day symbols, it was introduced by Berzelius, and we are using alphabets as symbols for each element. So now we are going to learn how the symbols came for each element. Okay, how the symbols came for each element. What are the sources of this symbols for each element? You had completed the slide, right, children? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
All of you, right? Okay. So this is the symbols of elements proposed by Dalton. Then we are moving to the modern day symbols. So before learning the symbols of each elements, how the symbols of modern element, modern periodic table came. Okay. How the symbols of modern periodic table came. So the first point, the names of elements were derived from the name of the place where it is found for first time. Okay. The names of elements, certain elements, not all elements, the names of certain elements, it was derived from the name of the place where they were found for the first time. Example, in the case of copper. In the case of copper. Copper was taken from Cyprus. Okay. Cyprus. It's the name of a place where it was found for the first time. So an element that is obtained from Cyprus, it is named as copper. That's related to its name, right? Cyprus, then copper. So the names of certain elements, they were derived from the name of the place where they were found for the first time. That's about the name of elements. And in the second case, some names were taken from specific colors. Some names were taken from specific colors. Example, gold. There is one element, gold, right? Gold. It was taken from the English word meaning yellow. Gold, it was taken from the English word meaning yellow. Gold means yellow color. Okay. Then, this is very important. IUPAC. Okay. IUPAC. It's an abbreviation. The full form is International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. I stands for international, then U for union, then P for pure, A for applied, then C for chemistry. So International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, they approved the names of elements. So if we are, if the scientists were discovering any element, they were discussing certain names. It was finally approved by this organization, IUPAC. International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. And many of the symbols are the first one or two letters of the elements name in English. Nowadays, we are choosing the symbols of each element by choosing the first two letters. Not in all cases, but in some cases, the first letter or the first two letters. First letter or first two letters of the element from English, it was chosen as their symbol. Okay. So first thing, that's about the names of the elements. The names of the elements were derived from the name of the place where they were found for the first time. Copper, it was taken from the word, the name of the place, Cyprus. Then in the case of certain other elements, it was taken from specific colors. Example, gold. Its meaning is yellow in English. Then nowadays, IUPAC, they are the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, they will approve all the names of the elements that were discovered. And many of the symbols are the first one or two letters of the element in English. Okay. Adigesh, can you please read the points?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
How the symbols of modern periodic table came. The names of the elements were derived from the name of the place where they were found for the first time. Example, copper was taken from Cyprus, a place from where it was found for the first time. Some names were taken from specific colors. Example, gold was taken from the English word meaning yellow. Now, IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, approves names of elements. Many of the symbols are the first one or two letters of the element's name in English.
Okay. Have you completed the slide, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, one minute.
Okay, okay.
Finish, ma'am.
Okay. Then we are moving to the room.
Ma'am.
Okay, sure.
Yes, ma'am, you can.
Okay. Then we are moving to the reasons for the symbols, or how can we write the symbols for each elements. Okay. So always the first letter of a symbol is written in capital letter or uppercase letters are used. Okay. The first letter of the symbol, it's always written as capital letter or uppercase letter. Then the second letter as a small letter. In some cases, only one alphabet that is used as a symbol. In that cases, you should write that alphabet in capital letter. If there are two letters for symbols of the elements, first letter should be in capital letter and the second letter should be in small letter. That's the method. So for hydrogen, we use the alphabet H as a symbol. So this H that we will write as capital letter. Okay. For hydrogen, we will write capital letter H. Then the second example, in the case of aluminium. In the case of aluminium, we will choose two letters, A and L. A and L. A is capital letter, L is small letter. So that means the first letter always written as a capital letter and the second letter as small letter. Then in the case of cobalt, also we will write CO. Okay. First letter capital, second letter small letter. So in the case of all these examples given here, hydrogen, aluminium, cobalt, we will choose either first alphabet or the first two alphabets as symbols, right? So you have to remember the point. First letter always in capital letter. If there is second letter, it should be in small letter. Okay, that's the first point. You write the first point, then we can discuss the remaining. Okay. Amaljit, can you read the first point?
Yes, ma'am. The first letter of a symbol is always written as the capital letter, uppercase. And second letter as smaller letter, lowercase. For example, hydrogen, H, capital, aluminum, A capital, L small, cobalt, C capital,
Oh,
small letter.
Okay. Then the second point. Symbols for some elements are formed from the first letter of the name and letter appearing the later in the name. That means we are not choosing the second letter from its name. Okay. We are not choosing second letter from its name. But when we pronounce which letters came, it will be as the second alphabet. In the case of chlorine, when you pronounce chlorine, it will be clo, right?
Yes.
First alphabet is C. The next one is L, right? Chlorine.
Yes.
Yeah. So we will write CL. Okay. So note in all cases, the symbols of elements is first and second letter of the name of the element. In some cases, we will choose another letters. That means when we pronounce certain names of the elements, which letter is pronounced second, that will chosen as the symbol of the second letter. Okay. In the case of chlorine, it is Cl. Then next example is zinc. Zinc, right? So first letter is Z and the second one, when you pronounce which letter came there? Zinc. N, right? Yes. So Zn. Okay. Zn. So this is another rule for writing the symbols of elements. Nandana, can you read the second point?
Yes, ma'am. Symbols for some elements are formed from the first letter of the name and the letter appearing later in the name. Example, chlorine, C capital L, small l, and zinc, Z capital small l.
Yeah. That's about the second point. Then the third one. Some other symbols have been taken from the names of elements in Latin, German, or Greek. Okay. Some other symbols have been taken from the names of elements in Latin, German, or Greek. Example, Ia. Okay, Ia. Its Latin name is ferrum. Okay, for iron, Latin name is ferrum. That's why we will write the symbol Fe. It's from ferrum. So Fe, it's from its Latin name, ferrum. The next one, sodium. Okay, sodium, its symbol is Na, capital letter N, then small letter A. It is from natrium. Na, it's from natrium. And the third example, it is potassium. Okay, potassium, its symbol is K. That's from kalium. That's from kalium. So these all from their Latin names. Iron, Fe from ferrum. Sodium, Na from natrium. Potassium, K from kalium. Okay. So this is another method to derive the symbols for elements. In the first point, we discussed about the first and second letters of the name of the element as its symbol. And in the second point, symbols can be also formed from the first letter of the name and the letter appearing later in the name. And in the third point, some symbols can be taken from the names of elements in Latin, Greek, or German words. So therefore, each element has a name and a unique chemical symbol. Each element has a name and a unique chemical symbol. Sridev, can you read the third point?
Some other symbols have been taken from the names of elements in Latin, German, or Greek. For example, Fe from its Latin name ferrum. Sodium is Na from natrium.
Yeah.
Potassium is K from kalium.
Yes.
Therefore, each element has a name and a unique chemical symbol.
Okay. This is clear, children, about the symbols of elements. Okay. So in the case of names of the elements, sometimes it will be taken from the name of the place where they were found for the first time. And sometimes it will from specific colors like that. Now IUPAC, that is the international, and in some cases the name of the scientist also gave for the names of the elements like that. So now IUPAC, that's the name of the organization, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. They approve the names of all elements. And the symbols of the elements, usually they are first one or two letters of the elements in the name, elements name in English. Okay. And in the case of symbols, sometimes we will choose the first and second letter of the name of the element itself. First letter in capital letter and second letter in small letter. And some other cases, the symbols of the elements, it was formed from the first letter of the name and the letter appearing later in the name. Okay, that means it related to pronunciation. Then the third point, some other symbols have been taken from the names of the elements in Latin, Greek, or German. Okay, So from this all points, we can conclude that each element has a unique name and its own symbol, right? A unique name and unique chemical symbol. Okay, clear children about the points?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then we can discuss the symbols of each element in the next class. So before the next class, you have to learn the first 20 elements in the periodic table. Okay, clear children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, then don't forget about the activity also. It's clear, right? The last date of submission, that is 15th September 2021. Okay. Then let me take your attendance. Just wait. If you have any doubt regarding the activity, you can ask me either through WhatsApp or you can call me. Adhikesh. Okay, children. So today we had discussed about the names of elements and regarding the symbols of elements, right? So what about the Latin word of sodium? Latin word of sodium.
Natrium.
Yeah, natrium. Then what about the Latin word of potassium? Alan, potassium.
Kalium.
Yeah, kalium. Very good. Then iron, Maria. What about the symbol of chlorine? Symbol of chlorine. Irene Maria. Symbol of chlorine. Lakshmi CV.
CL.
Yeah, CL. Jairus, what about the symbol of aluminium?
AU.
Is it AU?
AL.
Yeah, AL. AU for gold. Okay. The remaining symbols we can discuss in the next class. So thank you, children. See you in the next class.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. See you, ma'am. Bye bye.